not want to get out in these areas. You see that area in red that's circled here. Even though the rain is moving off to the north and east, the streams and creeks are still rising. All that water still on the ground trying to go somewhere, and those creeks are rising as a result. You can see more than an inch to an inch and almost a quarter here along Interstate 40 areas along those creeks. We have seen just rapid rises. You've got that flash flood warning up until about 1 a.m. Flash flood warnings in addition to flood advisories, which means other areas, poor drainage areas in the cities as we go north through Rockingham County up into Wentworth and Reidsville may also see some flooding, at least locally. So here's your warm front stretched out here, a coastal low and energy moving off to the north and east right now. We have big concerns from Brush Creek at Muirfield Road, rapidly rising creeks of 2 to 3 inches falling already tonight, and another 2 inches possible from Reidsville north into Wentworth, and then as we go up toward sections into Martinsville as well as Danville. So just intense rains. We still have that flood warning until about 1 a.m. Here comes the rain from about 5-6 o'clock, and then gets heavier. It sits with us for a little while, and now it is finally moving off to the north and east. But our flash flood warnings, just a reminder, as a result of those continued rise in the creeks, that's going to be in effect until 1 a.m. So 8+, we've already seen that come up to 9 feet now along Muirfield Road. So definitely messy weather. Don't get out on the roads now and drive in these locations. We still have rain to get through, and those creeks are continuing to rise. By tomorrow morning, though, things will be much better. You're going to dry out a little bit, and you'll start to see some cloud thinning. It's cool too. Upper 50s near 60 degrees. Winds are out of the northeast at about 5 to 10 miles an hour. This wind is going to switch tomorrow. It's going to come in out of the west, and that's what will help to warm you up. Take a look at some of those June rainfall totals. I think we'll be above more than 6 inches in Greensboro for the month, and this is all through tonight. Burlington also continuing to see some of those light showers bring totals up almost 6 in North Wilkesboro. Today, though, the heavier rains in the Triad rather than west, where we had the worst flooding over the weekend. So I'm grateful for that. Those 5 to 9 inches, they did not need much more, and they only had under a tenth of an inch in most cases tonight. 84 degrees typically. We hit 73, about 10 degrees cooler. Let's take a look. 61 degrees tomorrow morning. Sounds really nice. A little morning fog possible before the winds pick up. It's going to be gusty. We have to prepare also for some small trees to come down, maybe some power outages. And this is because we've got very soggy soil conditions across the Triad. Rain chances at 30%. Rain and storms a possibility, but not for everyone. This should be a little bit more spotty than what we had today. 59 degrees in the foothills with 73 at lunchtime and a rain chance of 30% later in the day. And I tell you what, 56 degrees sounds nice and cool. Grab the jacket, though, and maybe an umbrella, too, because you may run into some showers as we head into 1-2 o'clock in the afternoon. That continues for us until about 4 o'clock there. We should begin to clear out, though, in the Triad by around 5 o'clock. So showers right now continuing to lift north and east. We're under flash flood warnings in eastern sections of the Forsyth County area. You know, we're talking about all of those creeks and streams, Horsepen Creek. You're talking about Brush Creek, and then heading south out near Deep Gap, too. So we'll be watching for those tonight. 59 degrees in Reidsville, 60 out there currently in Greensboro with those temperatures that cool early and then warm right back up. Mid and upper 70s for you tomorrow. Should feel pretty good. A little sunshine working its way in, and notice how spotty the showers and storms may look with that front. The front is going to be great, though, because it brings in a dry air mass and drops our humidity, and we should stay dry until we hit, you know, the weekend going into late Sunday. I think you're going to enjoy those temperatures that are in the mid and upper 70s heading into your Friday as well. Thunderstorms, a possibility. Here's a look at your 7-day forecast, folks. 79 degrees today, 78 on Friday, and sunny. Gorgeous Saturday and 87 Sunday, with just a slight chance for storms late on Father's Day. We'll have much more.